I gotta put the front camera on here. Sorry, technical difficulties while I trade out.
So there yes, for those watching, we have just gained Jake Solomon, who, among other things, worked on the recent XCOM.
Right. Hey, how's... Oh, you like that? There we go. Okay.
Oh, are you going to do like a shaky cam thing, or are you just going to shake it the whole time?
I am. There we go. How's that? Is that good?
That's good to me.
Yeah, yeah, right. That's great. I just need to resize this window until it cooperates, and I can see both of you in this tiny
You can admire
box.
My new beard. Here it is. Yeah. I realize now I should shave, but...
it's okay.
All right.
That will...
Wait a minute. Whoa.
What?
Nate Grayson.
Yeah, that's me.
That's the American arm of RPS.
It is.
Yep.
Yeah. The secret American arm. Good. I was afraid I'd be outnumbered by imperialists again. And now I have a fellow colonist with me. We'll see if your tyranny will stand now, Julian. All right.
Well, but you won the game earlier. What are you talking about? You beat the Brits.
Oh, God. You're right. I'm an asshole. Never mind.
Well, that is kind of history repeating itself.
Anyway, I want my chance for revenge. So that's why I've dragged you back here.
All right,
and
that's,
so now
fair enough.
I'm gonna kick both your butts in the game. So
look at that. That's British trash talking right there. That is. Yeah.
Are you gonna create a game then, Nathan? It has to be three player this time.
Yep. ID is 133 and password is RPS777.
133.
ID. Wait. What's the ID?
133.
133. And the password is
RPS777.
777. Okay. All right. Let's see.
Oh, we're in.
Here we are.
All right.
Hold on. This was the. Is this the same map? No. Yeah. No, it's a different map to the one we had earlier. Actually, in our three-player game, but it's similar.
Yeah, it does have a similar terrain kind of setup to it.
Yeah.
Let's see.
Look at that. Yeah.
I'm going to have a look at my spells.
Can we do that? Wait, who's doing this? Is it my turn?
No,
it's my turn.
It's Nathan's turn.
Okay, take your time, Nathan.
But you got a view spells button in the bottom right there, so you can look at your spells while he's aiming his turn. So I'm looking at my spells, and I'm thinking, actually, this is quite a good selection for this map, is what I'm thinking. So I'm feeling good. I'm feeling lucky already. Although I've got some rather difficult to summon creatures, though. I'm afraid you won't be seeing any dwarves or goblins from me.
Oh, man, if I had a nickel for every time I heard that.
Oh, there's an eagle. I'm going to start running away already.
Probably a good plan.
It's fake. It's fake. It's fake.
Could be I'm going to get my own. I've got my own eagle. There you go.
Oh, my God, it's fake, too. You're both fake. Who am I talking to? I don't even think you guys are real. All right. See, gosh, I'm going to feel embarrassed if I can't summon an eagle right now. I feel a lot of peer pressure right here. Okay.
Goblin.
How do you know I have a goblin?
Well,
it does seem... I mean, there's a high probability.
You, Julian.
I was just kidding.
All right. Oh, my goodness.
Got a goblin.
He can see us.
Wow.
All right.
Okay. Let's see. No, that is not what I wanted to do. Can I undo that?
You might be able with right mouse button, you can undo a move.
Okay, good. Because I did not want my eagle to go there. That would have been bad.
Well,
right.
If your eagle... too close to mine. Mine's going to attack yours.
Exactly. And that would be a very unfortunate thing. Eagle on eagle crime is a terrible reality. Ooh, I have that.
Now, Nathan.
Yeah?
Nathan? Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light? One of these things is not like the other, Nathan. Okay, that's all I'm saying. Solidarity in the face of the nicest man we both know. That's terrible. To the man who I owe so much personally. You know what? I take it back. Julian, let's team up on Nathan. How about that?
Well, mine
needs to turn quickly. Unicorn.
That's fake.
Yeah, well, you can try disbelieving it then.
Is it? Whose turn is it?
It's still Nathan's. He's got his move as eagle. He's still. Ah, okay. I can see what he's doing now.
No, I can too. So
you moved
all right.
In that direction, which means I can move my eagle over in that direction without any problem. And I can go move my wizard the other way. And, oh, it's still not looking good for any particular direction of Lore of Chaos here. I'm going to try and go for an elephant. Oh, I failed. Can't have everything. So, yeah, now you can disbelieve the unicorn, Jake. It's up to you.
I know you want me to. I want to do it, too. I can't lie. I also want to disbelieve the unicorn. But
well, actually, you're not in any danger from the unicorn. You're actually more in danger from his eagle because it's going to go a range of four. Can't reach you next turn.
But if I move. All right. Liar!
Damn it! Look, maybe I just that was my imaginary friend.
Naughty Nathan.
You killed my imaginary friend. That's sickening.
I didn't kill him. He wasn't real. All right? So,
wow. Ouch.
No harm. No harm. Is that eagle real?
I don't know.
Now you have me doubting everything. Isn't this game great? I honestly, like, the bluffing aspect is maybe my favorite part.
Yeah, no, it's definitely really neat. Damn it. Okay. Got to regroup here. Lost my unicorn. Morale is at an all-time low. That's not a good idea yet. Captain Eagle here. Let's see. He will not quite be able to reach me yet. Things have become precarious. Ooh. Okay.
Oh. Skeletons. Skeletons are tough. That's a good cast there. I don't like the undead. I don't like the undead. It's hard. You know, the undead come for you. You have to have an undead creature or you have to have a spell, right?
And right. So, yep.
You basically have to run from them is what it comes down to.
There's no shame in running away in this game, by the way. No shame at all.
Yeah, it seems pretty advantageous in a lot of scenarios, seeing as your wizard's very weak.
Yeah, and now is your time to start running, Jake. And meanwhile...
I think so.
I'll bring up a...
Ooh, yeah. There's some sound feedback in the background.
Oh, I can hear my own voice. That's what designers love. Never mind, it's fine.
Oops, sorry about that.
Why is there feedback, though?
I just went to the page, but I didn't mean to the page.
Okay, no worries.
I must have clicked on something. Anyway, so, right, I've got to think of a spell here. I'm going for Magic Shield. Oh, and that failed. that was very bizarre. Okay.
It's embarrassing. It happens to every wizard, Julian. That's nothing to be embarrassed about. It just...
No. Well, I'm not worried at the moment. I'm not worried.
No.
Oh, that's one eagle down.
One eagle down.
Now, Nathan has to be worried about my eagle now.
Yes, I am actually very worried about your eagle.
You are in range of it right this minute, but Jake is not in range of it, and you've got to move anyway.
Let's see.
We need more creatures.
We do. Allow me to.
Interesting.
Yes. Now, is it real? Is it real? I don't know.
I don't know. I don't care at the moment. Until it comes roaring down.
Until it comes close.
Yeah.
Okay.
This really... Now, I honestly, like, this game is perfect. Design-wise, the great thing about this, it's straightforward, but, like, as you learn more about it, like, there's lots of very subtle things that sort of influence your decisions, like the... Like, I like the idea of the like the chaos meter, so you kind of set out your early spells trying to build towards your later summons. It's hard to get the dragons, so what do you do to get the actual dragons, Julian? Because they always are pretty low chance, right?
They are, but I managed to do it in my first game with Nathan. I got a gold dragon.
Got two
I was
dragons.
Pushing very hard towards... Yeah, I had two dragons.
Real dragons?
Yeah, they were real, yes. Yeah, I was pushing very hard towards lore to get the golden dragon, so I was summoning... multiple swords, which I didn't need, and but it kind of worked because Nathan didn't quite figure onto exactly what I was doing there.
Yeah, until there were two dragons, then I feel like I kind of got the point.
Yeah, yeah.
And did you do that by building earlier chaos spells towards them, or
I was building lore spells? Yeah, because it was a gold.
Okay, lore spells towards them. Yeah,
yeah. It's a lore dragon. It's a gold dragon, so I was building a lot of lore spells right from the start. Oh, is one way to deal with an eagle.
Yep.
Now I am feeling outnumbered. Seriously outnumbered.
Oh, I like my skeleton's little hop down the steps. That was adorable.
Oh, that was pretty good. He's a jaunty little fellow.
Oh, I've got to run away. Let's go that way for the moment, and I will... I need some creatures, but actually my creatures are all difficult to cast.
Then you should cast an illusion.
Yeah, I could do. I could do. Let's start with a centaur. Oh, no. Maybe not. Maybe not. Okay, you two guys can just fight it out for a while. I will
stay up in your little corner.
Well, I hope you don't come for me. That's all I can say.
I would never.
Yeah.
What reason would I possibly
have? I don't think I've earned the right to go after Julian. So.
Well, he didn't in the last game we played, I seem to remember.
Except that skeleton. That skeleton
I was going after you as well, wasn't I? Yes. It was a race. My skeleton going for you and your center was going for me.
All right. We're going this way.
Interesting.
Oh! Alright.
Oh, yep. It was real.
I don't mean to insult you, Nathan, by trying to disbelieve your skeleton there.
Oh, that's fine. I take it as a compliment.
It's just the game, right? It's nothing personal.
It's all
well played. Well played.
I got a feeling that's... Now, of course... Nathan, do you want your skeleton to defend your wizard, or are you going to go for me?
Well, I mean...
You know, that's a subtle way of saying keep your skeleton at home, Julian. I don't appreciate that. Nathan. He's vulnerable, okay?
No, I'm worried about Nathan. He's vulnerable.
No.
He's very vulnerable.
He's a master tactician. Don't listen to him, Nathan. I'm not going to hurt you. Send your skeleton after Julian and everybody gets out of this okay.
You sound very trustworthy, so. Let's see. What do I want to... No, save that for later. For now, let's try... Very unlikely move. Man, I wanted that.
Where's the skeleton going?
Yeah, where is the skeleton going? Well, if I were you, Nathan, I would just not do that.
This is why we start. There's still a chance to turn back. We don't have to do this.
No, you don't have to do it.
And then it's raining and we're on a rooftop.
I'm going to tell you why it's a bad idea if this succeeds.
You've made the...
Oh, it failed. I tried to subvert your skeleton. Didn't work, though. Could have worked.
No, my skeleton's too loyal.
He's real. That's why I thought subversion might work. on that particular case, because Jacob's already done the hard work of trying to disbelieve him.
This is true. Always happy to help. Let's see here.
I do really like that, because I feel like bluffing and disbelief are obviously a part of a lot of strategy games, but it's not usually baked so much into the mechanics of the game itself.
Right, yeah. It's explicit. I mean, I like that too, actually. It's explicit. And so I was saying earlier to Julian, I think it reveals your character. Like, I think everybody's character is an illusion, which means that I'm probably a paranoid schizophrenic, but that's just how I feel. Every creature that appears, I'm like, he's lying to me. That's a lie. So, not mine. Mine are real, but other people's are.
That also goes back to the paranoid schizophrenic thing. Like, you're rocking in a corner, being like, but mine are real. I know they're real.
That's right.
They have to be.
They're my friends.
Ooh. Oh. Okay.
Come on, you're gonna advance your skeleton. Come and get me. I dare you to.
That's a confident declaration.
Well, there's a lot of water between you two. I think he feels confident right now.
But then also, we have been saying that Julian is the ultimate deceiver, so maybe he's trying to call me out to make me second-guess myself.
Maybe. I do have a plan.
A plan, you say?
I do have a plan.
Ooh.
It's an interesting plan, and I'll see if it works.
Okay. Well, I have options here, but not enough to make me confident in that move. I will, however, just keep doing that.
Uh-huh.
And then...
Oh, magic.
Oh, nice.
That's the spell I didn't want you to have. because I'm going to retreat. I really hope this one succeeds. Will I be out of range of your bow? Yes, I will, actually.
I'm just trying to be quiet. You two just fight it. Oh, look at that. Now that's troublesome.
That's very troublesome.
Fortress.
This is the plot of Frozen.
And you can't get me with your bow. Now, the reason I did that is, I hope will be revealed later. It looks like I've boxed myself into a corner.
It does look that way.
But there is method in my madness.
Is it to wait until Jake's army descends on me?
Well, that's part of it. That's part of it.
Wish I had.
Well,
a fortress.
I offered you another way with your skeleton, but no, you insisted.
Ha! Huh. Well, that's unfortunate.
Sorry.
That was.
I feel like you're not actually sorry.
On some level, I am.
Okay.
Forcing my hand. Way, that's better. Yeah. See, the other thing you can do with Tanglevine is you can trap enemy wizards, and you don't want to be trapped.
Oh, that's a good point. I hadn't thought of it that way.
Yeah, I've used Tanglevine.
Oh! What?
Magic attack again. Oh.
Why did you do that?
Look.
Now.
I didn't like what your lion was doing over there. I did what I had to.
Try to summon a gold dragon.
Gold dragon? It's a little early for that, isn't it?
It failed. Well, I've got limited options at the moment.
You are protected back there. I guess that
I'm
makes sense.
Yeah, so I'm not worried about...
Can I destroy your vines with physical attacks?
Yeah.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
You don't
The vine
say.
Is not impenetrable.
Let's see here. Oh, Oh, this is tricky. This is tricky. Okay. Wow. All right.
Oh. I haven't really...
Oh!
Pegasus.
That didn't work.
Okay. Well, I've committed to this. So I'll stick with it.
Shadow would be really useful at this point. If you got it.
This is all very unfortunate. Take that.
Oh, you're still trying to attack.
I've thrown a stick at your thing of sticks.
Will you ever learn?
Look, I've committed to what I'm doing here.
I appreciate the commitment.
Oh, I'll try to summon another dragon.
Another gold dragon.
Didn't work.
Now, Julian, the failed spells, they don't push law or chaos any direction, right?
No, they don't.
But successful illusions do, right?
Yeah, illusions do, yeah.
Okay, all right.
Yeah. Oh, I probably should have cast one of my gold dragons as an illusion to start with, just to push it towards lore. I would have got a better lore bonus on the next dragon spell. But stupid me, I was greedy.
Let's see.
Have you cast a spell yet, Jake? Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
That was the Shadow Wood. Okay, it failed.
There was the Shadow Wood.
Yeah. That's a shame.
That is a shame.
We're not seeing a lot of exciting creature fighting in this game so far. It looks like it's going to come down to a wizard.
Not a wizard on wizard action here.
It's going to be like a last second everyone clusters together and destroys each other.
That's right. We're just going to slap fight each other with our wizards, you know, just...
Well, our previous match ended in both of us tangled in web, just kind of wriggling at each other. That was pretty great. We were side by side, too. We're just like, I'm going to hit you, not if I hit you first. It was very dignified, as I imagine all wizards to be.
As all wizard duels are.
Now, this is interesting, because Nathan's being pushed down the same little peninsula where I've got my fortress.
You do have a fortress.
And yeah, well, almost. It's pretty secure at the moment.
Hey, Julian, I have a totally abstract question which has no bearing on this duel right here, but does gooey blob require line of sight? I'm not interested, just abstractly, if I did have gooey
I mean, hypothetically
blob.
Speaking, if hypothetically, you do have one, then no.
It doesn't? Oops. Okay.
No, it doesn't.
Good.
Oops. Oh dear!
Not that I care, but
my
okay. Oh, it's open.
Exposed.
Gate
that's
is
right.
Down.
I've just got to. I've got no choice now but to do something risky. But I've got to do a magic bolt in the face. I'm afraid, Nathan.
I'm afraid you have to.
Yeah.
I want you to do that though. Don't I get a say in this?
Oh, but you survived.
My face is
trouble.
Pretty powerful.
Now I'm in trouble. It could be that I'm going down now. It could be I'm. We'll see. We'll see.
Oh man! All right. Let's see. That's not going to work.
Okay. Oh dear.
Neat.
All right.
Okay, so what's the attack power of my bow versus one of a magic bolt? That's also an abstract question that has no bearing on this current situation.
Magic bolt is much more powerful. Much more powerful.
Fascinating.
I mean, with your bow, you would get less than 50% chance on me as a wizard. With a magic bolt, you've got at least 70% chance.
Oh! You killed Julian!
Yes.
Well, that's one down.
You bastard! Who the hell do you think you are? What? How dare you? I don't worry, Julian. I will avenge you.
It was a bit embarrassing. Yeah, but I kind of... yeah, he was very persistently trying to attack me, wasn't he? Weren't you, Nathan? Yeah,
that's,
he was really going for me. I think that's just... He wanted revenge for the last two games.
Yeah, like a lot.
Oh.
Oh, no, that's bad.
That's enough of that.
That's real bad.
How dare you? I thought we agreed. Nobody touches Julian. I thought that was the whole deal.
Okay. This is looking a little dicey. But I have options. They are interesting options. I'm just going to sit there and attack.
You know, Julian, now that you're dead, you could you could give me a hand here.
Yeah, I can.
All right.
Well, in this case, Nathan's, he might try summon some more creature. But again, if you've got Magic Bolt, that's the ideal time to use it. If you've got...
I should move out of range, right? I mean, he could...
He could bolt you, but you've got a...
That's true.
You're okay. You've got an elephant, because if you're riding a mount, he has to attack the mount first. Okay, so even if he did bolt you, then you could just move away the next turn and he'd be out of range. So I don't think you're in any danger there, Jake.
All right.
No danger at all.
None whatsoever. I don't know. I've played enough Games of Chaos to know that there is no zero chance of danger.
Well, put it this way. No chance of danger for one turn. After that, it's difficult to say.
Right. Hard to predict. You are working on something big over there, I can tell.
I'm thinking through my options.
He's thinking really hard.
This is what happens when you only have a couple of options.
You can do is you can summon a creature which can then attack the goo blob that's sticking you down and free you.
Right.
Certainly from... I think from your point... Of course, you can always shoot with your bow, because I don't think the goo blob stops you using your bow, does it?
Oh, it doesn't. Are you sure?
I don't know. That's it?
Yeah, I think it does.
Oh, right. Okay.
Okay.
Hey, who made this game? Hey, yeah, Julian, what's the chance of the gooey blob spreading to a creature? Give me a break.
Oh, what?
What's the chance of the gooey blob spreading to his dragon if he summons it? All right.
well, this is terrible.
What's the range of a dragon, Julian?
Three. So he can...
One, two.
He can breathe fire on your elephant. You're just in range.
But if I move here? If I move one over, I don't know what to do with my goblin. All right, let's see.
Yeah, so you can't reach his wizard. You need something with ranged combat. And again, it's either magic bolt, or if you've got something with a ranged attack, like centaur or elf would be good, or dragon.
Let's see. Something with range to it.
Yeah, it's all you need, because he's not very well defended.
No, not really. I have a tuning fork on my... No, that's my staff. Never mind.
Yes!
Well...
That would do the trick, yes.
That just...
If it's real, of course.
Okay. Oh, damn it.
Julian?
Damn it.
Sorry.
Go ahead. Spend a turn disbelieving. I dare you.
Ah, so close. Having all the things I want in life. did you end your turn?
No. No, I didn't. I have my sad little goblin here. I can't do anything, right, Julian? I got this goblin right now.
Sorry, yeah. Yeah, I just need to end your turn. Sorry, yeah.
All right.
I
like it when the wizard dies of gooey blob. That always seems the most ignominious end to a powerful wizard king. Is
a fantastic word. Time for a high risk maneuver. Oh, it was an illusion.
Oh well.
I almost subverted
that. I feel a little embarrassed. That was not a real dragon.
Oh, the red dragon is free now.
Yes, it is.
Oh. Uh-oh.
The blob died out underneath him.
Okay, so why...
Okay, so actually, now, Jake, you're in some trouble. Oh, no. Both illusions.
No. I guess we're both guilty of the same crime.
Just like mine. It was a lie. We all know that.
Sneaky.
All right, let's see. Okay.
Such nice elephant hopping.
You're relying on the gooey blob to kill Nathan there, Jake.
I am a very conservative tactician. I think the 10% chance will catch up with them eventually. What is the chance of gooey blob to kill the
wizard? Let me just check. I think it's about 33%. Yeah, because the gooey blob's attack is 2 and his defense is 4. Yeah, so
honestly, most of the matches my friends and I play, they end in like death by gooey blob because those things are...
That's unusual. They are dangerous to a wizard. They are definitely dangerous. Yeah.
You're disabled and they have that chance to kill you, so...
Yeah.
Well, this is awkward.
Your best chance, Nathan, is to summon a creature to attack the gooey blob if you've got any creatures at all left.
Or submit, just, you know.
They could surrender, yeah.
I would never.
No shame in that. No shame in that. Just, in fact, honor, I would say.
It's fair.
I'm a terrible salesman. Terrible.
What can I really do here? So if that happens, that'd be bad.
Oh, Nathan, you're trying so hard here.
Yes.
You obviously got some different things you can do. But I kind of think a creature of some kind is what you need. Well, a magical attack might get rid of the gooey blob if you have...
Can I? Because I don't think I can attack the one that's on me.
I think it can. I don't know. You can try.
It doesn't display as an option.
You can attack.
No, I
doesn't
can't.
Attack it.
I can attack the one adjacent to me, but I can't attack the one that's
interesting.
On me.
It won't let them in. Okay. You probably should allow you to do that.
Yeah, that'd
now,
be really
useful. Julian, to wipe out all the gooey blob, you have to attack the key, the core. Is that right? To wipe them all out?
No, you just have to wipe them all out. Otherwise, they keep spreading.
Oh, wow.
Any gooey blob can spread. Even
I'm telling you, this game is like Revenge of the Gooey Blob. I'm telling you, gooey blob, you cannot beat gooey blob. It cannot be beat.
Well, it's my favorite spell. Maybe that's why it's a little bit powerful.
Damn it.
Well, that's...
Well, that was terrible.
All right.
What? My poor goblin has nothing to do. I need some sort of ranged.
Manticore's got ranged attack.
Now I have just a bunch of. I have a bunch of brutes. That's all I have left to cast are a bunch of brutes.
Well, move your elephant around the other way and start casting them.
All right.
The blood's going to die out at some point, though.
Right. All right.
I would like for it to do that. I think that'd be really cool. And I'm in support.
Well, you can hope that it does.
All right.
At a certain age, gooey blobs tend to start dying out. And that should be coming up soon.
Oh!
A giant would have been beautiful.
That would have just not made my day.
See, that's what's good. See, I was thinking, should I just do an illusion? Like, but then I think he doesn't have much to do, right? He's sitting there.
No,
he could just disbelieve me.
He might not have any useful spells left.
No!
But the blob
killed death by the blob. Blob!
The blob did it.
Death by blob.
Sickening.
Victorious again, Jake. Well, what can I say?
Man, I got to hang him up after this.
Practicing a lot.
Oh man, I tell you, I just want to point out that that it wasn't me that hurt you, Julian. It was
it wasn't. I mean, I did advise Nathan to go for you because you were the danger all along.
Yes, your advice became less and less subtle as the game went on, Julian. you're making it pretty clear what you thought he should do. So.
Yeah.
Well, it was sort of the transformation from Senator Palpatine into Emperor Palpatine, where it's like, it really was evil. Just fucking do it.
It really was.
Would you guys like to hang out and talk about strategy games for a little while? Like, we could play another match, but that seems to be very focus diverting.
Yeah, because you think very intensely about it, Nathan. So, I mean, yeah, it will be different. I mean, you can ask questions while me and Jake play a game. That'll be funny.
Yeah, that'd be awesome, actually. Let's do that.
But what you have to do is, what you have to do, basically, Nathan, is you start a three-player game.
Okay.
And then you just surrender on your first turn.
All right, I can do that.
If that's okay with you, Jake, if you've got a little time to spare.
Of course.
Oh, thank you very much.
All right, game ID is 188, and the password is once again RPS777.
Ah, good.
So, yeah.
Whoa, this looks similar.
Yeah, it's the same. We ended up the same map, unfortunately. Yeah, but you have to click surrender on
Farewell.
The top left. And now it's just...
I consider that a victory. I consider that a victory.
It's just a two-player game. That's fine.
All right.
I have got... Oh, this is an interesting selection. I've just got to go with the dwarf here.
Well, here we are, Julian. You and me facing off.
This is pure old XCOM versus
okay,
new XCOM.
Okay, but it's actually great, right. too, because it's kind
Nobody
of weirdly...
Nobody else interfering and messing things up.
It's kind of weirdly metaphorical, too, in that Jake is, you know, doing stuff at, like, a big, you know, AAA, big-budget studio, and Julian's doing Kickstarter route, and you're both doing strategy.
Yeah.
You're taking a very different tact on it. It's the battle
of
generations.
Yeah, but the thing is, we're both doing turn-based strategy here, and this is, you know, my favorite genre, and this is what Jake and his team at Firaxis have done. They've put turn-based strategy games on the map for
kept them there.
Well, yes.
So, I mean, do you think that they're on the map right now, or do you, because I mean, it feels to me like they're still a little bit niche, but maybe not necessarily in a bad way.
Well, I don't know what you know about the audience for the new XCOM, but I've read so many comments about from people who played the new XCOM who really never played any turn-based games before, and that's, you know, that is a bit unusual.
You know, and I think that it's a very, very, it's a big loyal audience. So it's obviously it's not. You know, it's not going to do, you know, strategy games probably aren't Call of Duty level necessarily. Although, you know, what was interesting to me was that when Beyond Earth was announced, which is the new Civilization game, I went to Reddit that night, just the front page of Reddit, and there were three posts about Beyond Earth on the front page of Reddit. It was amazing to me. So it's not as... I think it's not as niche as people think. I think that maybe it doesn't get some of the coverage, but it really it's really an let's see here. It's really my mind goes dead as I
have to think about tactics.
That's real. That's real, by the way. It's real. It's interesting. It feels like a really great time for strategy games, PC games as well. You know, it just feels like this sort of, I don't know, I shouldn't say renaissance, that's an overused term, but it really feels like a really good time for games like this to happen.
Yeah, certainly.
Yeah, I think so. And we've got some, the new Civilization just had absolutely awesome response, like you said.
Yeah, which is a really cool thing.
But there are some other really decent games coming out as well. Age of Wonders 3 is really nice. And Warlock 2.
Age of Wonders, yeah.
Age of Wonders, it's really nice to see that one back. I've played it a very little bit so far, since I haven't had much time. But it looks amazing.
Well, yeah, and I mean, when you're making strategy games, like, how many do you guys play?
I like to play as many interesting turn-based games that I can find, for sure. Both on PC and iPad. There's quite a few on iPad which are really good.
Do you end up having time for it, though? Because, I mean, one of the common complaints I hear from a lot of developers is just that when you're making a game, you hardly ever have time to really play them.
Well, it's true. From my point of view, it's more like research. I can't really afford to spend hundreds of hours playing it. I'll put, 20, 30, 40 hours into a game maybe to get a real understanding of how it works, and then I'll have to kind of move on to the next one. Now we've got a maneuvering game going on here.
It is tough. I don't I play probably a lot less than other people. It really is hard to find the time, and creatively you get so consumed with your own thoughts and gameplay ideas. For me, sometimes it's hard. It's actually hard for me to sort of let go and really enjoy other experiences, which, by the way, this is what's great, is that we play Chaos so often here because it is actually so fast. Like, we can just be like, hey, you want to play another game of Chaos? Hey, you want to play a game of Chaos? You know, like, that's part of what's really awesome about it.
Yeah, and that's one thing that attracted me to going back to the original game. It was this nice, quick turn-based game, which you could play a game in half an hour or less. If we weren't talking so much, I guess we probably could anyway. Oh dear, I'm in trouble now.
Well, but that is...
Oh no, you're not.
Yeah.
That is definitely an interesting avenue for strategy to go down too, because I feel like a lot of the people who may not necessarily be drawn to it do look at it as like a time sink. It's like, oh man, I've got to pour an hour into a match at least.
Yeah, and I really believe that doesn't have to be the case.
Although it is interesting to see, like, so on the one hand, you have that mentality, but on the other, you have games like League of Legends, which have average match lengths of, like around 45 minutes to an hour, gaining gigantic audiences.
Yeah. Yep.
So it's not necessarily true that people are scared off by match length.
No, that's true. That's true. Oh,
well, I don't know. It's actually one of my complaints about League of Legends. I haven't played it a huge amount. I felt that at a certain point the games did drag a little bit, but maybe it's improved since I played it.
Yeah, it can get a little attrition-y sometimes.
Yeah, it feels like, okay, I'm losing now. How long is it going to take before I'm finally...
Well, and yeah, that's one problem, is that teams like to turtle a lot when they start losing. So you're just like, okay, so it's already inevitable that we're going to take it. We just got to commit.
Now, I've done a useful little tactic there. I kind of blocked off any way for your eagle to attack.
You have...
I'm just wondering how many of your creatures are real.
All of them, Julian. There's too many to choose from. I dare you, find the fake one, all right?
Yeah, I know.
It's a shell game. Some of them are real. Some of them maybe not so real.
Yeah.
Oh, man. All right. Let's see.
So one thing that is worth pointing out about a lot of the more recent, like really big strategy games, the ones that a lot of people have been super interested in, like XCOM and like things like even the new Civ, is that they have a lot of legacy to them. Like, I mean, obviously XCOM, the new Civ is rooted in Alpha Centauri. How much of a factor do you think that plays in their popularity?
Well, I mean, I think that it comes from, I guess, like anything, right? A lot of it could come from just the being able to know that the product that you're getting has really strong roots, knowing that games are a lot of money nowadays, right? I mean, actually, Chaos is not, right? Chaos, the digital edition, is only $20 if you back it on Kickstarter. Is that right?
Yeah, that's correct. Yeah, $20.
But a lot of times you're talking about $60, $50, and that's so much. And it's really hard as a consumer to put that kind of money out there if you don't have confidence. It's just, you don't want to take that chance. And so I think that games that do have a legacy, games that do have a legacy, I guess they're more appealing because people know that they know the value there. And so games like Chaos, you know the value there.
Yeah. Do you think, though, especially with those bigger brands, or with really just AAA strategy, is there a danger of it becoming reliant on that legacy? Because, I mean, like off the top of my head, like those are the first ones that spring to mind, are Civ and XCOM, and then on the non-turn-based side, you have like StarCraft. And I mean, there are games right. like Age of Wonders and stuff, but a far smaller audience knows about that game than they do
sure. with
the bigger, more legacy-centric titles.
Right. I think that it certainly is something you have to be wary of, but you know, at Firaxis anyways, a lot of what we pride ourselves on is the ability to reinvent. And so we're just not afraid. We're just, and you look at all the awesome features in Beyond Earth, or you look at Civ 5 compared to Civ 4, and even the XCOM, which was inferior to the original in many, 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 many ways. We're just not afraid to sort of say, all right, let's shake it up and do what's best for design. And I guess that's what we're confident in, is our ability to sort of take chances as long as it, you know, as long as it makes the game more fun. And so I do think we have a history, at least the only people I can speak for is Firaxis, but we really value being able to sort of innovate, I guess is an overused word, but the ability to sort of change things up from iteration to iteration. I do think that's yeah. kind of essential, obviously. Yeah, so you kind of get the best of both worlds. You get the roots, but then you also get the to present people with new stuff. Did you subvert my eagle?
Yeah, I did. While you were talking so eloquently.
This is great. You just have this like Lord of the Rings standoff here.
Well, I was in trouble because the eagle could have attacked me. So now I'm feeling safer, and it's actually Jake who's got to be worried now, because the eagle has turned, and he actually needs to try.
Oh, that's a great book title.
I was going to say, like, looks like the eagle's on the other foot, but that works too.
Oh, it looks yep, like this move. Eagle came back to the party. Okay, that's a terrible line.
Yeah.
It looks like this eagle
double
came back
subversion,
to the
my friend.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's right. Quite unpleasant.
Yeah, that's pretty bad.
My dwarves are going to protect me. Okay, my two dwarves are going to protect me. What to do here?
Are those dwarves even real?
Oh, of course they are.
It'd be great if they weren't.
Oh, yes, your dwarf is probably not real.
How dare you? How dare you?
I think the only not real one in Jake's army is Jake himself.
The chameleon.
First of all, my dwarf is going to try and kill that blasted eagle. Oh, my goodness me.
Old iron feathers. Yes.
That is just unbelievable.
That's the eagle of freedom, Julian.
Okay.
And I'm proud to be an American.
Well,
my eagle will not die. All right.
It's not dead yet. I tried to subvert him again. It didn't work. I guess three times in a row is a bit much.
Oh.
Oh, my goodness me.
Looks like we're two dwarves short of a party.
The dwarves are supposed to be tough.
Oh, goodness.
Oh. Okay.
Man.
Let's see here.
It's not looking good.
Outrageous.
I really like your game, Julian. I really, really like this game.
Well, that's the start of a co-publishing / development deal if I've ever heard it.
Oh, you're just lining them up. They're on a line coming to get me.
Yeah, this is absurd.
First come,
I bet
there.
Some of those are not real. I bet some of those
I
are not.
I bet some of them are real.
You have a nice little conga line, though. You're really continuing that party metaphor.
Yeah, huh? Everybody line up. Everybody wants autographs.
Oh, finally.
Oh, man.
That eagle is dead.
It's a very dead eagle.
Oh, man.
Well, you killed freedom.
I'm going to have to take a risk, though. Because next turn, you're going to kill me. But what is the least risk? Maybe it's that one. No, you're still going to be able to attack me at least once, so... Okay, I'm going to take a chance here. If this doesn't work, then I am indeed doomed.
Oh,
man.
I think you can still shoot me with your centaur, though.
But my range is, what, 3 with the centaur?
You need to, but you can move 3. 1, 2. Oh, no, you can still shoot me. Ah, curses. Yeah, you can shoot me from 1. If you select your centaur, then directly click on my wizard, it will show you where you can shoot me from.
Oh, that's right.
Oh, man.
Oh, and you did it.
Man.
Namaste. Namaste. Okay. I didn't want to do that. I take no pleasure in it.
What can I say? Well done again.
Yeah.
Clearly, that's... you're a master.
Man.
Well.
Cannot be right. Beaten.
Can I just be kicked up to the god tier when in the in chaos? If you know, I'm just asking.
Kicked up to the god tier. Well, we'll see.
You can kickstart to the god tier for only.
Yeah.
What is it? 1,000?
Yeah, it is.
1,000 bucks. Yeah.
You can buy godhood.
You can buy godhood, but it doesn't.
Oh.
It doesn't actually make you a more powerful wizard, though.
That's a whole discussion in and of itself.
Yeah, no, I meant that more on like a metaphysical level, like you.
Right.
Yeah, I should emphasize that our rewards, which allow you to buy in at these social ranks, do not make you a better wizard, and you will still start as a level 1 wizard. So as a god, you'll be a level 1 god, probably having your butt kicked by ordinary wizards.
But you can tell everybody that you're a god.
You can tell everybody you're a god, and people can still worship you.
For instance, when you go to bars.
You.
Right.
They can still worship you, but...
not without value, then. Yeah.
But maybe not on the battlefield, won't do you much good.
Well, I have plenty more questions, so you guys can play another match or just talk the normal way.
Yes, now I do have to at some point, odd as it is, I do have to, return to work.
Yes.
Work. Not that I want to.
We did steal you for quite a bit, didn't we? Well, let's go for just a few questions then, Nathan. What have you got?
Okay.
And then, because a game will take rather a long time, I'll be humiliated again after all. So, we can do without that.
This way, I can end.
You can end on
3-0.